In this topic, we're going to cover Key Vault, which is basically a key store that you can use to you can store all your passwords and all your keys in a cryptographic way where Microsoft doesn't really see that, but you still have a way to access all those keys, and you have those in a little repository that you can pull into your different applications. And then Kel's going to talk through some of the use cases for this.
Yeah. So from a high level, like what I said, they actually call them HSM, so hardware security modules. So it's an implementation of that. So basically, a way for you to store secrets such that they're encrypted, and you don't have to store them specifically directly in your, like, let's say, application configuration files. Or in the case of something like disk encryption, there is no real good place to store those. So that's kind of like an interesting use case for where something like an HSM or a Key Vault would actually fit in. And so if we took a look at kind of overall what this would look like, we basically have... We provision what's called a vault up here. We mentioned Key Vault, but we provision what's called a vault. And once we have that, then inside of there, we're going to store an array of secrets, right? Each one of those is going to be associated with some sort of authentication mechanism for someone to actually access them. Also, important thing to remember is RBAC stands in front of this, right? So this the other modules we talked about, RBAC, which is basically a way for us to restrict access to certain things. So in this case, we could actually restrict access to humans, who may want to access these secrets, as well as apps, right? And this is kind of an interesting thing from an application perspective. So if we looked at a typical app, right, we have our app here, and we have some configuration. Let's do a simple example and say this is like the database config, right? We need to be able to talk to a database over here, and there's some sort of authentication that has to happen. Typically, that revolves around some sort of connection string or something in this configuration. What if we didn't want to store that in the app config? What are our options? Well, in the past, what we would do is encrypt this whole thing, which is possible. It doesn't work well in cases where we have like a web app. So if this was an actual web app inside Azure, we don't have access to the machine keys and that kind of thing in that machine. So we can't really use those same kind of modules. We have to do something different because we don't have low-level access to that actual virtual machine that's running our app. So in this case, it might be a good use case to use something like a Key Vault. And what we could do is actually install, we could either use a certificate that gets deployed with this application, which is a great way to do it. So once we have our little cert here, that guy is basically tied to a user. It looks like an app, but it's basically the same as this, and can come through RBAC. So we could apply RBAC policy essentially to the application. So now we could say, hey, this application's allowed to come in here and access this, but it can't do anything else. Can't create new things, can't delete them, it can only access as one secret. So we can set the policies on like which things it has access to. And then it's kind of up to your app developers whether you're going to store that in memory, which is probably a bad thing, just use it as needed over here and then destroy it so that it's not being exposed anywhere. So this is one way that from an application level that you might want to look at using Key Vault to allow your application to not have all your secrets exposed out there on its actual platform. The other one is virtual machines. So the other use case that works really good for Key Vault is this. So underneath that, and Ed had mentioned this earlier, we have VHDs, right, sitting in a storage account underneath this VM. And those VHDs, a lot of demand for, especially around regulatory things, is to encrypt this guy. So we have BitLocker and DMCrypt and all these different encryption technologies that do disk-level encryption. You think about it, though, the problem is, this guy is actually sitting underneath a hypervisor inside Azure, right? So there's a hypervisor, a host, that's actually running this VM. How does this guy know how to boot? Like, which key? So that's kind of the issue. Like, yeah, you could turn on encryption here, but then where do you store the keys? Because the hypervisor needs those to start this up. It needs to say, which one do you do? And that's the integration specifically for disk encryption. So when you enable disk encryption in Azure, you can actually store those in the vault, right? And this way, they're stored in a secure place, and the hypervisor has access in order to boot that VM so that he can decrypt the disk. Otherwise, he wouldn't even know what the disk is. He was like, I don't know. It's a bunch of garbage. It doesn't look like anything to me. So these are, I think, probably the two primary use cases for a Key Vault. These things can actually exist in a bunch of different regions, so you can replicate these things around. And they are HSM. There's an actual standard around this, so you should check that out if you're looking at your regulatory requirements around how you store your passwords or secrets and make sure that it fulfills those needs.
And so, Kel, I had a question about this. So you have here a diagram of one application or one VM accessing one Key Vault. do you see instances where you might split those keys into multiple vaults and then have different applications accessing different key vaults, or is it typically just having one large key vault with all the keys and then having all applications access
I typically see people creating, storing like related applications in the same vault, but not everything in one vault. Typically, it's like split up by maybe an application stack inside a business. It depends on how big it is. If it's a very complex application, they tend to be like their own vault. And then another app would be its own vault. But if they're very small applications that are just storing one or two secrets or something like that, there might be a tendency to kind of group them together. So kind of on an as-needed basis. They are isolated from each other, so as long as you apply the RBAC policies correctly, it really doesn't matter between the two. It's not like they're sharing something inside there. And so that wraps the module on Azure Key Vault.